Hi everyone. Today I'm going to tell you how to identify pyrite in reflected light. So here is a pyrite crystal. It's fairly distinctive in that it is hard, so it'll take scratches really well. So it's often fairly scratched. Also, it's got a distinctive light yellow color to it. And you can see rotating the stage, it's just staying that constant same color. So it is not bireflectant. So if it were bireflectant, it would be changing color as we change. Now we're putting in cross polars so we can see whether it's anisotropic. So if it was anisotropic, we should be seeing the pyrite changing colors as we rotate the stage. And it's not doing so, it's staying black. Now, sometimes it can be weakly anisotropic, but not in this case. All right, we're going to look at another sample, and this one has a few other minerals with you. So the bright yellow is chalcopyrite, and in the center, there's a kind of pinkish one, and that's pyrrhotite. Again, we can see the pyrite isn't changing as we rotate the stage. And you might think that it looks like a little bit paler than the last one, but that's because it's next to the chalcopyrite. Now, if we put it in cross polars, you can see that we have the pyrrhotite is actually coming in black to dark gray to black. That's what something would look like if it's anisotropic, which pyrrhotite is. One other thing to pay attention to is what we call relief. So you can see when we put it back into regular plain polarized light that the pyrite seems to sit above the chalcopyrite. And that's because pyrite is quite a bit harder, so it's more resistant in the polishing. All right, this is our last example of pyrite. And one thing to bear in mind going forward is these are pretty pristine samples. So some of them are showing nice cubes. Mostly it's more kind of jagged edges, not perfect crystal form. But pyrite can have a lot of different crystal forms. But that's a subject for another video.